Okay, good day. So we have to know the draw the shear and moment diagram by this triangular load. So we have 5 kN per meter and 5 meter distance. So we have to know this reaction RA and RB. So this is the resultant. So we have 1/2 base times height. So we have 1/2 times 5 is 12.5 kN. So as you can see, this is the 1/3 of 5. So we have 5 of all 3, and this is your 2/3 of 5, so we have 10 all over 3 for that distance. So we have submission moment at A is equal to 0 clockwise to B positive. So ito yung reference natin, ito yung base natin. So we have 12.5 multiplied by 10 all over 3, okay, minus, this is counterclockwise RB, okay, multiplied by 5 is equal to 0. So we have RB is equal to 12.5 times 10 is 125 all over 3 divided by 5. So that is 25 all over 3 kilonewton. That is for the reaction at B. So how about reaction at A? We have submission moment at, or submission force is Y is equal to 0, upward is positive. So as you can see, RA and RB is positive. RA plus RB minus 12.5 kilonewton is equal to 0. So we have RA is equal to, okay, we have 12.5 minus 25 all over 3, so that is 25 all over 6 kilonewton. So that is for RA. Okay. Okay, next we have to draw the shear diagram. So sa shear diagram, yung shortcut na yung gawin natin. So, alam naman natin, this is 0. Kung nasan yung pinaka-small dyan na parang ito, angle na yan, dun tayo lagi mag-start. Okay? For example, na-flip yan. So, nandito yung pinaka-ganyan. So, pwede kayo dito mag-start kasi dito siya naka-base as 0, 0. Ano po? Okay? Pero this time, nandito siya sa left side, so that is 0. So, ngayon tataas tayo. We have 25 all over 6. Ayan. And then, this is 25 all over 3. So, ito, pag ginawa natin yan, that is 2 degrees. Bakit 2 degrees yan? And this is first degree. So, therefore, kung ang area load is first degree, therefore, ito namang area shear natin is second degree. Therefore, yung moment natin na diagram is for the third degree. So, spandrel na po yun. Okay? So, we have to know the end. So, paano yung end natin? Ipa-plot lang natin yan, okay? Okay, so mapapansin nyo rito, we have your end. And then, ito ay zero shear. So, ibig sabihin, yan, i-plot natin hanggang dito, this will become your end. And therefore, kapag kinatin ko yan, that is your shear end. And this is your x. So, gawa tayo ng ratio and proportion para mahanap natin yung x. Okay, by ratio and proportion, in-isolate ko lang to. We have y all over x. So, ibig sabihin, pag mag-ratio and proportion tayo, dito tayo sa big triangle. So, we have 5 all over 5 is equal to y all over x. So, that is equal to 1. So, therefore, y is equal to x. So, kunin natin to. Resultant for this. So, we have 1/2 times base, which is x. And then, times this 1 height, which is equal to x. Kasi sabi dito, y is equal to x. So, therefore, you have x squared all over 2. Okay, next, ito naman, lagyan natin yung reaction. That is 25 all over 6. And how about this one? This is your shear n. So, para malaman si x, ito yung gagawin natin. Summation force is y is equal to 0. Upward is positive. So, we have upward 25 all over 6 minus ito, x squared all over 2 minus vn is equal to 0. Tingnan nyo to, where vn is equal to 0, so therefore, 0 yan kasi 0 yung shear natin. Okay, transpose natin to, so we have x squared all over 2 is equal to 25 all over 6. Ito, itaas nyo lang siya dyan, so we have x squared is equal to 25 times 2 all over 6. So, lagyan natin ng square root para makancel yan, so x is equal to 5 square root of 3 all over 3. So, that is the value for your x. Okay? Okay, so since ito yung shear diagram natin, ito na yung gagamitin natin para saan po sa moment natin. Alam naman natin yung area 1, that is 2/3. Diba? Bakit naging two-thirds? Kasi alam natin ito on our previous topic or previous subject. We have here this area to be your two-thirds of the area. Diba? And then this one naman is one-third of your area. Okay? So, nung ibig sabihin niyan, dito po ang pag-compute is more an area. So, how do we compute for A1? A1 is, that is two-thirds multiplied by the base, which is 5, square root of 3, all over 3. And then, multiply natin yung height nito, which is 25 all over 6. Okay, what is your area 1? Area 1 is equal to 8.18753. So, that is, lagay lang natin dito. Drop natin to. And then, lagay natin yan. This is your 3 degree. Okay, lagay lang natin yung value. So, we have 8.18753. Okay, next. Paano naman natin i-compute yung A4? Bakit A4 yan? Mas maintindihan natin yan kapag isosolve natin dyan ng mas maayos. So, ito kasi kapag ginawa nyo one-third of this area, mali na po yung sagot nyo sa moment. Hindi na siya sa magsi-zero. So, ano yung pwede natin gawin? Ito po, okay? Okay, dito, mapapansin nyo, nag-drawing ako dito ng parang triangle natin, pero one-third of this area. Ayan. So, meron tayong 25 all over 6, and this is 25 all over 3. Yung block na lang gamitin ko para mas nakikita. Okay, 25 all over 3. So, paano natin makukompute yung A4 para mag-zero dito? Ganito po yan, ha? Itong big triangle dyan, yan, cut natin yan, and then nilagay ko as free body diagram. As you can see, we have area 1, area 3, area 2, and area 4. Pero ang kailangan ko lang dito is ito, ayan, yung may area 2, 3, and 4. So, ibig sabihin, this big, ganyan, okay, spandrel na tinatawag natin, that is your area total. So, ano yung area total natin? Ito po kasi, okay, kunin mo yung height niyan, ito po yun. And then, this one naman, that is 25 all over 3. Ibig sabihin, ito yung distance niya, which is 15, 5 square root of 3 all over 3, and this is 5 square root of 3 all over 3. So, para malaman yung area total nito, we have 1/3 times base, which is, itong total nito is 5 meters. And then, this one also, kapag pinag-add mo yan, we have 5 kilonewton, meter. Or roughly, that is 12.5. Yun yung gagawin natin. Kasi resultant tayo. Okay? 12.5 kilonewton. Okay? So, we have 1/3 and 12.5 multiplied by 5. So, area total is equivalent to ilan po? So, we have here area total to be 125 all over 6. Okay? Next, kunin naman natin yung area 2. Ito tayo, area 2. So, di ba, 1/3 din siya? So, ilagay natin yan, area 2. So, we have area 2, 1/3 times, ano yung base niyan? Ito yung 5 square root of 3 all over 3. And then, yung height, that is 25 all over 6. Okay, pag pinag-multiply mo yan, that is equivalent to your area 2, 4.0093, paki-store na lang po kay A. Okay, next, we have area 3. Ano naman yung area 3 natin? Rectangle lang yan. So, we have 15 minus 5 square root of 3 all over 3, multiplied natin ng 25 all over 6. So, ilan yung value? We have 8.805 20 store kay B. So, paano i-compute yung area 3 natin? So, madali lang naman ang mag-compute ng area 3 natin. Ganito lang. Area 3, area 4. So, we have area 4. That is equivalent to your area total minus natin ng area 2 minus ng area 3. Diba? Imagine, this total minus area 2 minus area 3, makukuha natin yung A4. So, what is your A4? So, that is equivalent to 8.0185 or 753. So, equivalent niyan is magzi-zero na dito. 8.08753 minus 8.018 8753 is equal to 0. So, magzi-zero tayo parating sa moment natin. So, this is your moment diagram. So, as you can see, 0 shear tayo and 0 moment. So, tama po yung calculations natin for your shear and moment diagram. So, that's it.